Welcome to the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department Hall of Justice, the Sheriff's Department headquarters. We're proud to work with many of our providers and other county departments, including County Animal Care and Control, to tell you about a major operation that was conducted by our Community Partnerships Bureau in conjunction with spcaLA and the Humane Society of the U.S., as well as Animal Care and Control and the District Attorney's Office of Los Angeles County. Essentially, what occurred was the seizure of more than 7,000 birds that were used for illegal purposes. Deputies on scene conducted various phases of the operation, which included several hours of securing a large remote area. This was initially a dangerous tactical operation. It included more than 100 personnel from the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department. We had animal care and control experts on standby, knowing that we would potentially have dangerous or rabid animals as well at the location. Our goal was to safely and humanely seize these animals and have them protected moving forward. Captain Jeff Perry was from our Community Partnerships Bureau, was in charge of the operation, as well as our administrators from SPCLA and Humane Society, who can provide intimate details of the operation. Also seized at the location were firearms and illegal narcotics. And Captain, without further ado, I'm going to introduce Captain Perry, who can provide many of the details of the operation.
Good morning. Again, I'm Captain Jeff Perry, and I command the Community Partnerships Bureau. Before I start with some of the details of the operation, I just want to introduce the other people up here. We have from the Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Los Angeles, SPCLA, the President, Madeline Bernstein. We have Mr. Eric Sakich, who's the Senior Law Enforcement Specialist of the Humane Society of the United States. We have the Director of the Los Angeles County Animal Care and Control, Marcia Maeda. We have Deputy District Attorney Kimberly Boresk, again representing the DA's office. Yesterday was the culmination of a months-long investigation in which detectives from my bureau who specialize in animal blood sport crimes culminated a search warrant in which we knew there was a location that had a large-scale cockfighting rooster operation. The search warrant was served yesterday, and it was up in the unincorporated area of Val Verde, which is in the northern part of Los Angeles County, near Santa Clarita. As a result of the search warrant, in excess of 7,000 birds were located and seized. This, according to the experts here, is the largest seizure in U.S. history of illegal cockfighting roosters. The majority of the birds were the types of roosters that are commonly used in cockfighting. The property where the search warrant was served was very large and in a remote location in a canyon. Again, as the chief indicated, approximately 100 sheriff's personnel were utilized to safely secure the location and assist animal care and control in processing the location. Our other assisting sheriff's units included our Aero Bureau, which provided helicopter support, our Emergency Operations Bureau, which provided command posts and logistics. We had our crime lab out there to assist in processing the scene. And we also had mounted enforcement deputies on horseback who patrolled the canyons as some of the suspects tried to run up through the canyons, and that was the only way to stop them was because there were no roads accessible by vehicle, was to have these mounted enforcement deputies on horseback. Several pieces of evidence were recovered which were indicative of an illegal cockfighting operation. This included mobile fighting pits and the rings that they used to have the roosters fight with each other. Hundreds of gaffs or slashers, and what these are, and we have some examples up front, are they actually put them on the rooster's claws, so when they do these fights, they literally slash each other to death. We also found syringes and steroids, and what these people do is they inject the roosters, with steroids to enhance their fighting ability. We also found evidence of recent cockfights at that location, as we found several dead roosters with wounds consistent with cockfighting, slashing wounds and those types of things. At this time, we detained approximately 10 people at the scene. Most of the detainees were more the lower level, the caretakers, the people that were, again, entrusted with feeding and caring for the animals at the scene. We have identified the property owner, and he is the primary suspect in the case. The investigation is ongoing, and we anticipate to make several arrests in relation with this case. In summary, I want to thank all the other agencies that are here that were a part of this search warrant operation. There's no way we could successfully conduct an operation of this magnitude without the collaboration of all of our partners. And in closing, I just want to say and remind and to educate the public that any type of animal blood sport activity is a serious crime and will not be tolerated in Los Angeles County. If anyone out there is aware of any animal blood sport activities, I urge you and the department urges you to call your local law enforcement agency or any of the agencies up here. There are tip lines, again, even just calling the local law enforcement agency so we can take care of this problem. At this time, I'm gonna call up the director of Los Angeles County Air Animal Care and Control, Marsha Maeda.
Good morning. The Department of Animal Care and Control is, first of all, very grateful to the Sheriff's Department, the District Attorney's Office, and our animal welfare partners from the spcaLA and the Humane Society of the United States. As was mentioned, this is the largest cockfighting operation in U.S. history, and more than 7,000 birds have been identified at the facility. This is very serious. There's a lot of animal abuse that goes on with fighting roosters and associated crimes, as you've heard about that today. We had about 50 officers and medical staff at the facility, and that's still not enough to handle these numbers of birds. So we're very grateful for the help from HSUS and the SPCLA to provide additional animal caretaking staff to assist us with this. The department takes animal cruelty very seriously, and we really encourage anybody who has any knowledge about rooster fighting, dog fighting, or any other animal abuse or neglect to contact our department, and we can refer you to the right agency if it's not our jurisdiction. Our phone number is 562-940-6898. That's a 24-hour communication center where we can take your complaint. We encourage anybody to speak up about animals that they see in this sort of situation, because there really is a lot of abuse that goes on, and we want to see that end. And again, we thank the Sheriff's Department and DA for taking such this matter so seriously and recognizing the impact it has on our community's well-being and safety. Thank you.
Your name
again? Marsha Maeda.
Next, I'd like to introduce Mr. Eric Sakich, the Senior Law Enforcement Specialist, Humane Society of the United States.
Thank you. Good morning. As the captain mentioned, my name is Eric Sakich. That's E-R-I-C-S-A-K-A-C-H. I'm Senior Law Enforcement Specialist with the Humane Society of the United States. Earlier this year, the Humane Society received complaints from area residents about suspected cockfighting going on in Val Verde, the Castaic area, about which we in turn contacted Los Angeles County Department of Animal Care and Control and their Major Crimes Unit, which specifically looks into these sorts of crimes in the county. We subsequently learned that the site had been the subject of a seizure, a search warrant and seizure in 2007, at which time approximately 2,700 birds had been seized. The current search, executed by Los Angeles County Sheriff's deputies with assistance from LA County Department of Animal Care and Control, SVCA Los Angeles, and the HSUS, has resulted in the discovery of between 6,500 and 7,000 game fowl, making this the largest seizure of gamecocks, fighting cocks, in U.S. history. Cockfighting involves two roosters being forced to fight to the death, often with at least one or both birds dying a violent, agonizing death. The activity still exists as a serious problem throughout the country, with cockfighting events where tens of thousands of dollars in unreported income are wagered and exchange hands through illegal bird sales. This type of activity is also frequently associated with other crimes, including illegal bird sales across state lines and in foreign commerce, in violation of federal law, as well as gambling, drug dealing, illegal gun sales, and violence against people. Of the approximately 7,000 birds on the property, veterinary personnel found that many are suffering from infectious respiratory diseases, suspected at this time to be reportable to the state of California. Testing is currently being done at a state lab. Our concern is the health and safety of the state's poultry industry and the public's health. We encourage Los Angeles County to adopt an ordinance similar to what other counties have passed in the state that have helped significantly cut down on the number of operations like this, essentially ordinances that limit greatly the number of roosters that can be kept on a parcel. We also have a tip line at which people can call to report any sort of animal cruelty, puppy mill, dog fighting, cock fighting. That number is 1-877-TIP-HSUS, and the translation for that is 877-847-4787. And that's all I have. I'd like to introduce Madeline Bernstein, SPCA Los Angeles.
Hi. Thank you very much, and good morning. I can't tell you what a great team is behind me. And aside from what you just heard about, the horrible things that can happen as part of cockfighting or dogfighting and the ancillary animal abuse that goes on, it's also on fight night very often a place where other crimes are committed. We've seen slot machines, prostitutes, and then lots of children are present. And so from our perspective, it's also something where if you want to pay it forward to get our next generation to not be desensitized to blood sports and acts of animal cruelty, this is also an important area to look into. But to realize how great this team is in the planning stages, the investigation surveillance discovered that there were a lot of loose dogs on the property. The property had goats, a peacock I saw, there was a cow, a lot of horses, but there were a lot of loose dogs who, in theory, their jobs were to guard the roosters who were tied up one at a time. And so this sheriff's association and my friend Marsha and Eric were all concerned about all types of animals that could be on the scene. And not only that, but with an officer going in on a search warrant, if those dogs charge them, we could have the additional problem of dog attacks or officers having to shoot dogs who were doing really nothing but guarding their roosters. So the SPCA-LA elite group of humane officers went in with the entry team to make sure that the officers weren't put in a position of having to kill any of the dogs and to make sure that they were safe and that the dogs were handled. They went in with both lethal and non-lethal weapons. I have a little thing here, pellet. I just realized it's coordinating with my jacket, so I guess it's really important to always have your bullets coordinate with your jacket. And it's full of powder. And so basically, in the event that the dogs were charging the sheriff's officers, we would be in a position to have both lethal and non-lethal means to protect both the sheriffs and the animals. And I have to tell you, this is really rare. You almost never see a law enforcement institution sit there and worry about, we don't want to have to hurt a dog if we're going in and executing a search warrant. So these guys really are top notch in terms of a holistic approach to animal cruelty. So I'd like to thank you. I'm honored to be here, that we were able to send up staff and officers to assist with this operation. We also have a tip line, which is 1-800-540-772, which is 1-800-540-SPCA. If you have any ideas or you hear roosters in your neighborhood, typically they will wake you up in the morning, to please call somebody and get some help, because, you know, these crimes don't happen in a vacuum. There's always a lot of crimes that appear in the same place, and my hat's off to the team behind me. Thank you very much.
So Sheriff McDonald and his team wanted to make a clear message of the fact that animal fighting in blood sport is cruel, it's inhumane, and it's against the law. And the Sheriff's Department will work with our service partners, Animal Care and Control, SPC of LA, and the Humane Society to ensure that our animals are safe and that this cruel and inhumane blood sport and animal fighting is stopped in Los Angeles County. Right now, our technical team has some B-roll of the seizure and the search warrant operation and some of the activities that occurred.
But there's like these, there's like campers and trailers just. Yeah, see, so the rooster sitting on top of that barrel.
A lot of times, these horses, these are all, a lot of them are breeders. Yeah. And they'll breed those fighting birds.
Are you going to
the dogs?
The neighborhood here.
Farm. Treat the birds.
I don't see any people, but there's a, you know, like makeshift home and whatnot.
Hey, the guy we were detaining is now in custody, and we have pushed to the giant oak tree on the.
Possession with intent.
I can't get one of them while it's coming. But this dude is way good.
As you can see, it was a very large location with, again, about 7,000 birds. Just to remind you, we do have some examples of some of the evidentiary items I talked about earlier. And at this time, I'd like to call everyone back up here, and if there's any questions, we'll take them at this time. Well, again, like Eric was saying earlier, there was another search warrant operation back in 2007 in which they recovered about 2,700 birds, and now we're up over 7,000. So it appears that shortly after that initial one was shut down, they started back up, and it's grown even bigger. And this place, they did have some of the pits and the fighting things, but we think this particular location is more of a where they breed and raise animals and then sell them to supply the stock for this kind of activity all throughout LA County and neighboring counties.
Same owner in 2008
as now? Correct. Correct.
Is there any effort to try to seize the property or legal grounds to seize the property?
As far as seizing the property, that would be we'll have to go into the abatement procedures, and if the DA wants to speak to abatements at all as far as seizure property.
That's under investigation at this point, so.
Step forward,
I'm sorry. Kimberly Aberesk, Deputy District Attorney. That's.
If you've got two occasions in about an 8-year, 9-year period where you have this type of suspected activity breeding ongoing contributing to cockfighting and blood sport, can you not go after these people, seize the property, or criminal activity, use of space, anything like that?
It is something we're looking into. It's under investigation. That I do not know.
Can you spell your last name?
Aboureck.
Your title?
Deputy District Attorney and Animal Cruelty Coordinator.
Yeah, one thing, or maybe your colleague over there, a criminal investigator, could. What do these roosters normally go for? You said they were breeding them and then selling them to people who then stage the fight. What do these animals go for, and how lucrative is it for them to breed these animals and put them out for?
It's extremely lucrative. Birds at the very lowest end, single gamecocks, again, at the very lowest end, will sell for between $75 and $150. More often, when we go online to some cockfighting websites, you'll see these birds selling for $250 on up to $1,000. In some cases, for birds that come from cockfighters who have a widely known reputation for winning, their birds will go well into four figures. When they're selling birds, they're often selling across state lines in violation of federal law. Also, sometimes they're selling to other countries, also in violation of federal law. Those are federal felonies to move any animal in interstate or foreign commerce for fighting purposes.
So it's safe to say this was a multi-billion-dollar operation at a minimum?
I don't think there'd be any problem saying that given a period of a year with birds that would be sold out of there, you'd be looking at millions of dollars. I'd have to know more about what each person's doing and selling. The problem here is that statistically, Cockfighting is among the safer crimes that people can commit. You know, raids are rare. Opportunities like the one that everybody just participated in here are rare. And these guys are gamblers. They bank on the idea that they're not going to get caught. And if they do, it takes a real good effort by the district attorney's office to see that they're properly prosecuted and the courts to see that they're punished. We do have some elements under California law statutes that allow the properties used for this purpose, especially when there are arenas found, to be declared a public nuisance, in which case they'd have to remove all animals forever from that site. And we're hopeful that might be one of the avenues that the DA's office can look at too as well. Yes. For years, when I first started, I worked in an undercover capacity. I've attended well over 100 cockfights across the country, over 500 arrests and convictions based on those operations. The fights, the knife styles of fights are particularly bloody. There are several types of implements on the table up here. The type that look like curved ice picks, those are called gaffs, and they're worn on both legs of both birds. The shorter implements that look like a scythe or a knife are actually referred to as Mexican slashers or short knives. Those types of implements and the longer knife are only attached to the bird's left leg. In those events, there's typically a time limit of 10 to 15 minutes at the end of. It's not unusual for one or both birds to be dead. It's only the last bird that attacks its opponent that is a winner. The gaff styles of fighting, where the implement again looks like a curved ice pick, the bird is being stabbed repeatedly to the chest area. Most of the time the damage is done to the chest area. It's not unusual to hear a bird start to vomit up or regurgitate blood, the sound of which is a rattling noise, and you'll hear spectators around the arena saying that bird's rattled, and you'll see the betting odds change very quickly. That's also where we see some of these bizarre behaviors with cockfighters during a handle. If they've got a bird that's rattled, they know it's going to die. But if there is a handle called by the referee, you'll often see these guys put the bird's head in their mouth and suck the blood out of the bird's throat, because that may buy the bird a few extra seconds of breathing to be able to attack its opponent and win the fight. It's not unusual for us to find live birds thrown in dead pits or in burn barrels at the end of these events. Those are felonies, and California is a felony state. It takes a second or subsequent conviction to do it. But if we have mutilation occurring on the birds, if we have birds being thrown into burn barrels alive or being buried alive, which is very frequent, we can charge felonies as well. So this is an extremely bloodthirsty type of activity. It dates back thousands of years. It's not unique to any particular culture, contrary to public belief, no more than it was very popular in colonial America up until the 18th century. So it's just an activity that's out there. There's a lot of money involved, a lot of opportunity for money to be made, very low risk of being caught, not going to pay a tax consequence unless you're caught and somebody turns you over to Franchise Tax Board or IRS. Most of the money that's made is pillow money or mattress money. So it's a very difficult type of crime to go after.
I think you mentioned, too, that this is associated with other serious crimes.
It's been associated with Mexican drug cartels. In fact, a number of cities in Mexico have outlawed cockfighting. Federal government of Mexico just last month also made dogfighting illegal throughout Mexico, all 31 states. Cockfighting, I think, is we're going to see the same thing happen within the next few years. They understand what a blemish it is on society and how much crime is attached to this. But it's not unusual for us to find illegal narcotics, illegal weapons. There were weapons found out there yesterday, including a shotgun on one location that had the numbers filed off. Narcotics is very, very frequent. And as Madeline pointed out, the advent of children, that was one of the things that disturbed me most in my early years, was the fact that some of these people brought children so young they had to be carried, and exposed not only to the element, the criminal element that was there, and all of the violence and bloodletting, but to frightening aspects when we bust in. I mean, with a SWAT team coming in.
They'll put the gun in the kid's diaper.
Yes.
Being mad.
And shoving the money down.
And shoving the money into the diapers and stuff. So then you're in a position of having to search the children.
And the children are traumatized by that. And that's no way to raise kids. We all know that. We all know the deleterious effects it has to a child to be exposed to a constant source of violence, environment of violence. And that's something really that tugs at you. It would at anybody.
Can I add one
thing? Yes.
For those of you who don't realize, this is also a big operation. Marsha, we had one where they actually had a giant food truck and amusements for the kids pulling in to serve tacos. So the kid thing really bothers me too. But for those of you who actually can't picture what a cockfight looks like, unfortunately, I've, like Eric, have soul-searing images of being at cockfights. Most people ask, how does the chest get hurt? So let me just give you the nursery school thing. The reason the cocks are tied up on those barrels and the reason they're taking steroids is because they're building up their power and their ability to jump. And why? Well, they're just not fighting this way. But for those of you who know what a jump kick is, do you know? I mean, I can't. Okay. So a jump kick, right? So what happens is we can do a jump kick on one leg and kick, in martial arts, kick high with our other leg and then hit somebody in the neck or the face or the chest. What the birds do is they lift themselves up together and then both legs can go. So they can actually do a series of those, and that's how they're slashing this way, which is how the blood starts to, pool in their throats and stuff. So if you can picture that, that's how they get up so high, and that's why the steroids and the exercise of jumping up and down the barrels is so important for them, because it builds up their ability to have endurance and to be able to sustain those kicks throughout the fight.
Right now, we've identified him, and it's just still under investigation at this time, and I can't comment further on any more than that. He's not in custody at this time. Well, again, anyone that's involved in the breeding and possession of the birds are guilty of a misdemeanor. At this time, again, we know most of the people there were the lower level caretakers, and we've identified them, and they're the ones that provide a lot of information. So at this time, again, we haven't charged them with anything. It doesn't mean down the road they won't be charged. Not at this time.